This video is based on Pelican optimization algorithm code implementation. In this video, we will try to understand the code implementation done for this algorithm. What is Pelican optimization algorithm and how it is working? We already explained using numerical example in previous videos. For more details, you can check the link given below in the description box or in the comment section. In this video, we will try to understand the code implementation for Pelican optimization algorithm. First of all, you can see here we have the output when we tested Pelican optimization algorithm using a test function f1. So this is the best position, and here you can see the best solution obtained, and here you can see this is the convergence curve obtained for this test function. Now we will try to understand the code implementation for this algorithm. We will create three files, one for the test function information, where we will provide all the important details for the test functions, one for the Pelican optimization algorithm, where we will apply the algorithm on the test function, and the main file to run the code. First we will create the test function file. So first we will create the test function file, where we will provide all the important details related to the test function. In this file, you can declare the objective function that you are trying to optimize using Pelican optimization algorithm. Here you can see a function is declared. In the function name, we have test underscore fun underscore info. This function name should be the name of your file. And next, we have the to test function. You can see here we are using two test functions here for this algorithm. For first test function, you can see the lower bound we have -100, upper bound that is 100, dimension that is 30. For second test function, we have the lower bound -10, upper bound 10, and dimension is 30. Next, we will provide the test function details. So first we will define the f1 test function and then f2 test function. So here you can see this is the sphere function. So here you can see we have two functions that we will write in the code. Now next we will create another file for the Pelican optimization algorithm. So here you can see another function is created, and the function name we have the POA, that is Pelican optimization algorithm. And when we will run this code, in the end we need best solution, that is the best fitness value, best location, that is the best position, and the solution convergence curve. As you can see here, as output we need convergence curve, best position, and best solution. So here we have the best solution, best location. So here this function will return best solution, best location, and the convergence curve. And you can see here we have the input parameters like population size, maximum number of iteration, lower bound, upper bound, dimension, and fit t, that is the fitness function. Declare the limits for the upper bound and the lower bound. And next we will initialize the population for agents randomly in the search space. And using this equation, we can initialize the population randomly. So here we will initialize the population from I is equal to 1 to D. D is here dimension, or you can say the number of design variables. So 1 to D we will initialize the population. So here we have dimension for the first test function 30, and for second test function it is also 30. So here x denotes the agent position, and I means agent, that is I is equal to 1 to population size. So position for the x1 means position for the first agent, x2 for the second agent, lower bound, and rand is here any random value. Then we will apply this equation here, and randomly we will initialize the population for the agents in the search space. Next we will apply the objective function on the initial population, and we will evaluate the initial population performance in the search space. So here we will calculate the fitness value for each agent in the search space for 1 to 2 population size. For all agents we will calculate the fitness value. So here we will apply the test functions that we declare in previous file. Here you can see fit t, it represents the test function. So here we are applying the test function on the initial position for all agents, that is from 1 to population size. Now you can see the main loop for this algorithm start. First we will select the best candidate, that is the best agent among all, and here you can see minimum fitness value is declared as the best agent. So here we will update the agent having the minimum fitness value as the best candidate. So here we need the best agent value and the best agent location, that is the fitness value and the agent position. So in the population we will check the agent having the minimum fitness value is declared as the best candidate, and we will save the fitness value and the position for that agent that we will display in the result. So here we will update the agent having the minimum fitness value as the best candidate, and we will update its position and we will save its position and location. Next we will update the target location. So here we have the virtual environment, we have the virtual search agents, that is Pelicans. So we have the virtual target, that is the virtual food for the Pelicans. So here we will randomly initialize the target for the Pelicans, and we will consider the one Pelican among all as the target, that is the food, as we have the virtual environment. Same we did in the cat and mouse optimizer, where we consider the 50% population for the cats and 50% population for the mouse. So here we will update the target location. So here you can see we are randomly selecting an agent from the population size. So we are selecting one agent from the population size as the target for the search agents, and we will note the agent position, x denotes the position, and the fitness value for that agent that we will use in the upcoming slides for the comparison. So here you can see the target location is now updated. Target is randomly selected from the population size, so one target is randomly selected, and then we will save the target position and the fitness value that we will use further to update other agents' position. Now we'll start the exploration phase, where all agents will move in the search space and they will try to find out the target. So here you can see from 1 to population size. For all agents, we will update their position in the exploration phase. Here this is the random value that is either 1 or 2. Now we will update agent position in the search space. Here we will compare the agent fitness value with the target fitness value. And if this condition is true, then we will update agent's new position using this equation. So here new position is equal to its older position plus rand, that is any random number, then target location, and we have the agent location. Else we will update using this equation. Here new position is equal to older position plus random value into agent position minus target position, and then we will check the search space boundary whether the new position that we obtained for the agent, it is within the search space or not. So here boundary check is done. The new position we obtained for the Pelican, it should be maximum than lower bound and minimum than the upper bound. After that we will update the agent's final position, as we already discussed, in order to prevent agents moving in the areas where there is no optimal solution. Here effective position update is done. So we will update the agent only if its new fitness value is better than older one. If the new fitness value is not better, then we will consider the older position for the agent. So first we will calculate the new fitness value for the, so here you can see new position is calculated for the agents. For all agents we will calculate the new fitness value, and after that we will compare the new fitness value with the older fitness value. If the new fitness value is better, then we will consider that. Next we have the exploitation phase. In the exploitation phase we can update the agent's position using this mathematical model. Here this is the neighborhood radius, and this is the random value. So new position for the agent in the exploitation phase is calculated as its older position plus neighborhood radius, where r is constant, that is 0.2, then 1 minus t divided by maximum t into 2 minus rand minus 1, then its older position. And the when the new position is calculated, again we will check the boundaries, whether the new solution be obtained, it is within the bounds or not. It should be maximum than the lower bound, and it should be minimum than the upper bound. Next, the final position update is done for the agent, where we will calculate the new fitness value for the new position, and then we will check the new position is better than older one or not. So here we will compare the new fitness value with the older fitness value. If new fitness value is better, it means the new position is better. So we will consider the new position and the new fitness value for the pelican, else we will continue with the older position. And in the end, it will return the best solution, that is the best value, best location, that is the best position, and the convergence curve for the best solution found. Now last file, we have the main file where we will run the code. So here we will provide all the details, like the test function that we want to apply, total number of search agents we are using here 50, that is the population size, maximum number of iteration 500, that is how many times this loop will repeat, and after that it will display the best solution. Then we will load the test function details, here you can see, and after that we will calculate, and after that we are using here Pelican optimization algorithm to calculate the best solution, position, and convergence curve. And using this, we can draw the convergence curve for the solution. Here you can see X level iteration, Y level we have best value title, and then we will display the solution, and here we will display the best position. If we are converting this from number to string, then display the best location and display best value, that is the best fitness value found. So here you can see the output for the first test function f1. We have lower bound minus 100, upper bound 100, dimension is 30, and you can see the best position found, this one, and solution is 289.1019, and this is the convergence curve. And when the second test function is tested, you can see the lower bound we have minus 10, upper bound is 10, dimension is 30, and best solution found is 6.0041, and this is the convergence curve. Another test function F3 is also tested. Here you can see the lower bound is 0, upper bound is 1, and the dimension we have 3. You can see we have 3 dimension. This is the best position and the best solution, minus 3.8628. And this is the convergence curve that we obtained for this test function. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.